Hey guys, it's Wolley here, and I've got a super exciting video for you today. I'll teach you how to speed up your Windows device, whether it is a laptop or a PC. I'm going to walk you through in detail how you can fix your slow device without any software or paid programs. These fixes are completely free, and I'm going to walk you guys through each step in detail. So be sure to watch all the way through. With that being said, let's get right into this video. The first fix you should consider doing is the power option. For this, just go to the Start menu and search for Power option under Result. Just click on the Power Efficient. The default option is Balanced, but you need to change it to High Performance. After that, close the window and continue to the next step. As for the second fix, what you have to do is that you should clear out your startup programs and services. As time passes and you install additional applications, many of them force themselves to start with Windows. This has got to be the leading source of slowdowns. And if you don't close them, you'll have an increasing amount of apps soaking up resources while running in the background. However, don't assume that since there aren't many running apps visible in the taskbar, there aren't many operating in the background. The next method can be done by going to Startup tabs. So you right-click on Taskbar and Task Manager and go to Startup, and in this list, you can disable unwanted apps from automatically starting up when your device is turned on. So in here, disable any programs that you don't want to start up for no reason, but make sure that you do not disable your antivirus or Microsoft apps, which are these who under publisher have Microsoft Corporation name. This should make a massive difference, but the next method is even more effective. In Windows 7 and older, choose Misconfig from the Start menu. Then right-click on any services you don't often use and deactivate them. Naturally, you may manually run them whenever you wish, but they are not required to start up. Now, this is where most people fumble, because the Startup tab is not the end of the story. Because many apps install what are known as services, which are really just background programs that you never see. So the next step is to go through these startup services and disable any of those you don't need as well. You can actually do this by opening Services.sc from the Start menu. All of the services will be listed to you, and those that have Automatic next to them will launch with Windows. You may set their startup type to Manual by selecting them using the right-click menu so that they only launch when the program does. Remember that you should be extra cautious when deactivating them, particularly for applications that aren't always manually run by you. So, for example, disabling the printer service might cause trouble next time you go to print. Therefore, only disable those services you are certain you do not need to be running in the background. This is also fantastic for apps that you frequently see starting up but cannot locate in the startup list. Most likely it is a service. It should go without saying, but uninstall any unused programs. This will clear up hard disk space and remove startup trash, without requiring you to go through the entire list of startup applications and services to figure out what each one performs. This step is considered the most important by the PC Helpers community, and it had to do with temporary files. Now, to take care of them, go to Start and type Run, open the Run command, and here you have to type %TEMP%. Press OK. And once this folder opens, press Ctrl plus A to select all of the file, and then right-click to delete. Once you're done, you are going to have to repeat this step again, so click on the Start menu, type Run, select the Run result, and type TEMP, temp without the percent symbol, and press OK. When the folder opens, press Ctrl plus A, select them all, and delete all the files in that folder. Now one more time, we have to again go to Start, type Run, open it, and type Prefetch, P-R-E-F-E-T-C-H. When you are done, press OK. And once the folder opens, you should again press Ctrl plus A to select all the files and delete them. Defragmentation is the next step, so right-click on the Start menu and type Defragment and Optimize Drivers, and click on it. Here you have to select the C drive where the operating system is installed, and click on Optimize. It will take a few minutes to complete the defragmentation process, but after it is done, simply close the window. The very next step is a similar process to defragmentation called disk cleanup. To perform this, you need to do is to right-click on the C drive and select Properties and then click on Disk Cleanup. Click on Disk Cleanup. This does not mean that it will delete all files, but it will only remove temporary unwanted files. After it's completed, this window will pop up, so on this you should click on Clean Up System Files. Then press on OK and confirm the deletion of the files. This other step has to do with visual settings. So in order to get the best visual performance, go to the Start menu and search for System. Once it pops up, click on the System, and then go to Advanced System Settings. Here you should click on the settings of Visual Effects Processor, Scheduling, and Virtual Memory. Here you have to change the option to adjust for best performance. But if you want to take it a step further, you can also enable some features by selecting or deselecting them. Whatever you may find visually useful or not. After you're done, click Apply and then click OK. So with that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe down below for more interesting content like this one, and also don't forget to hit the like button. With that being said, thank you again for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.